Hello, good afternoon. My name is Chekube Madichie, and this video is for beginners of EVU, those who have not really used EVU before, but they are interested in learning how to use EVU to perform certain econometric tests. So here is my computer desktop background, where of course the EVU has been installed, as you can see from the pointer. The EVU version here is version 10, and today's video is to learn how to create a work file, EVU work file, from where we can perform every other test. So the title of this video is Getting Started with EVU, opening a work file in EVU from where you can perform every other test. So I'm going to open this EVU software. Here we are now in the environment of EVU. Okay, the next thing to do here is to click on this file. You can see a lot of items here on the file, because we are trying to create a new work file from where we can perform any or every other test on EVU. We can go to new. You can see new here. From there you get to work file. Okay, what we can see here, you can see work file create. So this work file create, there are a lot of options in building up the work file depending on what you want to achieve. So here you can see work file structure type, where if you click on the drop down key, you see unstructured, so undated. So if you pick this option, you are actually trying to build a kind of work file that can be used to perform tests on cross-sectional data. Then for this, we have a dated stroke regular frequency for time series and the rest of them. So this is on balance panel for panel data analysis. So for this video, we are going to be working with assuming we are working with a time series data. By implication, we are going to click on dated regular frequency. So this specification, we can see the drop down key here. We have multi-year, we have annual, semi-annual, we have quarterly, monthly, as we can see all of them here. So assuming we are working with annual data, where we have, assuming we are having a 2000, 2001, 2002, that's an example of annual data. So multi-year, you can be having a 5-year interval, after from 1980, 1985, 1990, as the case may be. Then we click on annual data. Here we have the start date. You can assume we are working from 1970, and the end date, we assume we are working closing at 2015. Here you write the name of the work file depending on what you want to do. Okay, because we are beginning, we can just write a test, and every other thing, this doesn't really matter. You can call it page one, because you can still create another page within the same work file you are working with. So you click OK. Now here we have the work file created. It's always advisable for you to click Control Save, save the work file, so that as you progress, as you do anything, you save your work file, so that in the event of the system going off, you will still be able to continue from where you stopped. So this is the work file we are working to create. We have actually created the work file. It's a very simple process to follow. Okay, from this work file, we can perform every other type of data analysis, running regression, performing all sorts of econometric modeling, estimation, and policy analysis. Okay, first of all, we have to ensure that the data we are going to import into the EVU work file is ready, preferably in an Excel file. Okay, now what we are going to do is to move to that Excel file and look at the variables and the data we have. Of course, you can see RGDP, MOP. RGDP is real gross domestic product, MOP is manufacturing production, and TOP is trade openness. It does not really matter the variable name or which acronym you are using to represent your variables. What really matters is the description, what they stand for actually. So you can see the data range from 1970 to 2015. As we can see here, we are going to work and find a way to get this data as we have it here into our EVU work file. Now, what are we going to do here? Having seen that the data is ready, what we're going to do here is to, you can look up here, you see various items there. You start with quick. Can you see quick? Yes, click on quick. You see a lot of things here, but we are going into the empty group where we have edit series. This will lead us to the EVU spreadsheet where we can now import the data. So look at the EVU spreadsheet, just like a Excel spreadsheet. So this is where we are going to import the data as well as the variable names. So what we are going to do is to ensure first of all that the scroll bar here is at the top by clicking up. Now we already have the data, can see the variables here. So what we're going to do is to write the variables the way they appear here in our EVU work file spreadsheet. So you click on this column, we have RGDP, you click enter, you leave it at numeric series. Okay, you click here again, MOP, you click enter. Okay, TOP, enter, click OK. Now you can see that we are seeing NA. NA here means not available, that we have created the variable names but the data relating to them has not been added. So that's why we are seeing NA, which means not available. So what we are going to do now is to now go back to the Excel and copy the data. Okay, copy the data. User way of copying, we move back to the EVU and you click here, right click, you paste. So now we have pasted the data. Of course, what we have here, this spreadsheet is in edit format. So it is in edit format, which means we can add or remove data from here. And now, having copied our data into the EVU work file or spreadsheet, you can see that everything is complete here. Having done that, we are going to close the edit by clicking on edit here. You can see the pointer. Once you click on it, it will close the edit. As it is now, you cannot edit again unless you click again on the edit. So that is it. And we have to also name the group. You know, this is a group when the variables are arranged in a tabular form having all the series, we call it group. So we have the group one here having the data we have imported into the EVU work file. So you can name it group. By default it is group one, the first group in the work file, it is called group one. So you can name it. So now you can now close this, you know, we can now close uh can now close this. It is already saved in the work file, so you can see the group one. You can always open it. Okay, can close it. Can see the series MOP. Can open it individually. You can also see the RGDP. You can open individually. You can as well see TOP. You can open individually. So here, those ones are called series. Individually, they are called series. MOP, RGDP, TOP. They are called series. While the group of everything, when you group them, it is called group. Remember, the resid is still here. The constant parameter is still here to register the relevant information for and get them ready for further test. Okay, this is one way of importing data into the eView work file. Alternatively, for the pros, those who are who have been have had clear knowledge, actually better understanding of eView, can as well use another method to do that. Now, for you to do that, let us first of all close this work file and go through the alternative method. And the alternative method is rather faster than this particular method. So we close this down and learned how to create variables and input the environment the way it is now. This is the EV environment. It is very much blank now. So we go back to the Excel sheet, and having our variables and the data ready, we can highlight and copy. So we can copy it the way it is, copying everything together. You can see from everything we copied, including the time, that's the year, RGDP, MOP, RGDP, MOP, and TOP. So we have copied and we are moving back to eView. So if you come into the eView environment as blank as it is now, you can right click and paste. So now when you paste, you move to next. Okay, move to next. You come here because this series is not named. You can name it here because it shows the time range of this thing, the variables. So we click next. The essence is to ensure that every other thing has been automatically arranged. It has been arranged automatically. So the next thing to do is just to examine and see that everything is in order before you finally click finish. So it has automatically created the work file, but this work file does not have a name because we copied and still named it untitled. So it is untitled work file, which means you can rename it by going to save as. If you look at this save as, you can save the work file, can call it a file, can call it anything, can call it test 01 because we have already a test saved here, and this test here has the previous method, so we can save it. You can see now that we have created the registered and imported our data and variables into the work file using alternative method. Okay, we can also make them a group because they are still in series form. We can highlight this, you can open them as group by right clicking, open them as group. It will come back to what we had in the previous video. Okay, you can see now we can now name and it will save as group one. Okay, can close this. So we have succeeded in importing, creating variables and importing the relevant data into the eView work file. So at this point, we are going to the next is actually to start the various statistical analysis depending on what we want to achieve. Okay, depending on what we want to achieve, we are going to start with doing tests like descriptive statistics, correlation analysis, regression analysis, and every other test that revolve around econometric research. Into EVIEW work file for time series data. So this time around, I'm going to show you how to do the same thing for panel data. Okay. Now you can see that our work file is blank. Here we are in the EVIEW environment. What are we going to do? We click on file. You can see we click on new. We want to open a work file, another work file, and this time around we are going to open a panel data work file, and of course input our data into the work file. Now, like I will always say, there are two methods you can actually follow to do this thing. You can first of all arrange your data in Excel file, and alternatively you can do through the manual method. So this one I'm going to do now is to follow the manual method. Okay, so what do we do? We click on this work file structure. Okay, and here we are going for panel. Okay, it's balance panel because we have equal time interval for all the panel. So this is going to be an annual panel. So it's a time series panel, and the data is annual. So the data range from 1995 to 2015. So number of cross section here, if you know the number of cross section, how many countries are involved, it can always mustn't always be countries, can also be group of firms you are studying, but this time around the panel is about countries. Okay, so how many? We say 20 for our own case. So you can name the work file panel. Okay, here this is what you do if you are following this very method. Okay, this is how you begin. Now you click OK. Now you can see that we have created a work file for panel work file. So what is remaining now? Here you can see cross ID, we said is 20 countries are involved. Okay, 20 countries are involved. You can see the other one, date ID, and date ranges from 1995 to 2015. So can you see that? So now what do you do at this point? What you do is to click on quick. If you click on quick, you will see empty group. You can see empty group here. Okay, see empty group here. You click on it, so it's going to bring out a worksheet for you. Okay, in this worksheet you can now start inputting, creating the variables. What are the variable names? Remember, this has been arranged already. Okay, and of course I said you must have arranged your data in an Excel file, or you can also use manual method to input the data one after the other. Of course you know how long it will take you to do that. So here our Excel, it has already been created. You can see that now. See the date, see the country. Okay, you can see the country, all the countries, 1 to 20 countries. Okay, you can see the country ID, it's still 1 to 20. Okay, and you can see the variables in question. So we have this variable name and this variable name. Okay, we go back and input those variable name. So the first one is BUDG. Remember, you make sure that this is up here. Okay, the first one is BUDG, I think. You leave it at numeric series, and click. You are going to see not available for all these ones. So this one says this, okay, and the other one says, what do I have for the other one? Okay. So this is what we have for the other one. So now this is what we have here. What it simply means now is that we can quickly copy the data, just as we have here now. We can quickly copy this thing and paste there. Okay, so you can see I've copied it, I've come to this point and place it here, and now click Ctrl paste. Okay, Ctrl V, Ctrl paste. Okay, it will be pasted. So when you finish doing that, what you are going to do is to click on edit plus or minus so that you will lock it up, and after which you name the group so that it will be named within the work file. So now we have used the first method, and this first method, you have to go through the EVU work file. You begin with the EVU work file and set up the work file in panel structure. And of course, remember, the information you have is that you must first of all know the number of countries, you should know the time interval from which year to which year. Such information is very, very vital if you must do it with this method. Now I'm going to do the one of alternative method, like I told you. If you like, you can save this thing, you can close it up. So now let us do the one of alternative method. Remember that I explained the need for you to have created a work an Excel file and arrange your data there. If you look at this Excel file here, you find out that everything has been arranged. So this is the date, say column. This is country from country one to the next. This is country ID, and these are the variables. So you can see the arrangement here. Okay, you can see how this is arranged. But the difference between this method and the previous method is that the previous method we have done cannot show you those countries, but can use their ID to identify them. So, but this one we show in the work file the name of the country. So here what we are going to do is to copy this. You can see the way we arrange this. So just copy, okay, highlight everything and copy, and go back to EVU. So in this environment, you right click and click on paste. Now if you click on paste, you go to next. Okay, you go to next. Now on this next, you try to examine what you see here. If everything is okay, you continue. So here now you can now see that we are seeing a different structure of this work file creation. Okay, you can see where it says input method, okay, create work file. Now you can see dated panel. So you can now see that you have several other options here, but here it is said dated panel, and because it is arranged in time series, so that is dated. Okay, it ignored other this thing. Undated panel is also here because there are certain other panel that's cross-sectional without a time range. Okay, now this is where it's supposed to be. So everything that you see here is still the way it is supposed to appear. So that is the benefit of using this very method, because once you have managed to arrange your data in an Excel work file, everything is just for you to copy and create your work file. So it's a link imported series and alpha from external source. You can say no, you can say yes, but if you click anyone, this is what we are going to see. So this thing we see here is similar to what we obtained from the previous method. You can see the difference between the two methods. Remember that I have also given you, for the time series work file creation, I also gave you two alternative ways you can actually create a work file, the faster one and the one you have to go through the work file and provide certain information to EVU to be able to create it. Now you can see, if you open this country ID, you are going to see from country 1 to 20.
If you open country, you are going to see this. Can you see all the countries arranged here? So I said that the benefit or the one thing about this one is that it's going to give you all those countries by their name, while the previous method will only identify those countries.